Let us perform convolution between an exponential signal and a unit step function. We start with writing a formula of convolution integral as y of t equals to minus 2 plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. In the first step, we change the index from t to tau for both x of tau and h of tau. Then we sketch both of the signals. X of t, that is x of tau, is an exponential function. H of tau is a unit step function which is coming 2 units earlier than tau equal to 0. Followed by that, in the next step, we perform folding operation over h of tau. Thus, this is a folded signal. Then we perform shifting of the folded h of tau signal, which becomes h of t minus tau, where the time instance we have chosen is t plus 2. By putting t as 0, we can make sure whether h of t minus tau results same as that of h of minus tau. In the next step, we start shifting h of t minus tau over x of tau, which is fixed. As a first case, since both signals, they don't overlap, output of convolution is 0, which is decided by the instance t plus 2. Unless and until t plus 2 reaches up to 0, the overlap will not take place. Hence, when we compare t plus 2 with 0, it reaches out to be the instance of time when is less than minus 2, output is 0. Output will remain 0. In the next case, when h of t minus tau has crossed tau as 0. Now both x of tau and h of tau, t minus tau, both of them, they overlap. And they overlap in the region from 0 to t plus 2, which decides the limits for integration while calculating the output y of t. This area will remain same for t plus 2 greater than or equal to 0. Thus, output y of t will be equal to integration from 0 to t plus 2 for e raised to minus 2 tau into amplitude 1 for h of t minus tau d tau. After integration and substituting the upper and the lower limit, output is 1 half into 1 minus e raised to minus 2 t plus 2. And the final output can be expressed as output is 0 for t less than minus 2 and is the one what we calculated for t greater than or equal to minus 2.